You know, this story starts 10 years ago. Basically, the deal was that Hunterra was going to start providing maps for Whitetail Properties clients whenever they would close a farm. Little did I know that was really going to be the beginning of a whole new chapter for me, for Kate, and for Hunterra. And we tag-teamed and essentially helped promote Hunterra to the world and make custom maps for the American landowner and hunter. With Whitetail Properties exposure, that really took our small little hobby business to the national level fast. As we grew the business, we knew quickly that we had a choice between either pursuing that career, where I was working at the National Counterterrorism Center, making maps for briefings in the intelligence community, or we were going to pursue Hunterra. I knew that we needed to get to the Midwest and really chase what I felt strongly in my heart we needed to do. In 2014, Kate and I decided to sell everything we had in Washington, buy this 79 Airstream, and hit the road and really create a new chapter with the goal of growing Hunterra. And then ironically, soon after we moved, they offered me a position as one of their land specialists in Eastern Iowa. Whenever the opportunity came to become a land specialist with Whitetail Properties, it was a no-brainer. Thankfully, as we've made some really good decisions with Hunterra, it's grown and Kate now basically runs the company, and we've got a great team of people that surround it that are really helping grow it, a lot larger than just myself. I'm dedicated to my land real estate clients now. I knew that I was built for this career. I'm a people person. I really like to work and chase really what matters to me. When I help somebody buy a farm, I really do so with the intentions of them creating their own future. And it's all kind of a paradigm, right? When you buy a farm, you may have certain expectations, and my goal isn't to sell somebody a farm. My goal is to allow them to see themselves on this property and creating a future of their own for it.
Oh, what is that?
A book.
Oh
my goodness.
Look at that.
It's a book.
When that happens, that's a winning strategy, and it really sets them up for success for the future.
Heavy.
He is heavy, Dad.
Yeah, he's way heavy.
He's really thick.
He's got a kicker right here. That's one thing I did see coming in. And then as soon as I saw this and this mass on this beam, there was no other question. I was grabbing the bow. So in 2016, I killed a giant whitetail out of the same tree stand. It was a hanging hunt. I was new to the farm. Picked it out on the map as a really good looking inside corner, jammed up against some really thick habitat. To me, with a northeast wind, that just looked like the right spot. So heading into this season, I thought, man, I'm gonna wait for those perfect conditions to be able to hunt that again. Because if you know mature bucks, once you find a spot that they're comfortable in, other mature bucks are probably gonna find comfort in those same areas. And so when you encounter a big deer, you need to remember that spot and think about why he's using that certain area and then how you can take advantage of that with certain wind conditions and certain weather conditions.
So Daddy was up there and the big buck came from back here and he came right on this trail, really close, right in between those trees, and I shot him with my bow and arrow. So we go find him. All right, let's get on the trail. Can you help me track him?
Southeast Iowa, it's November 5th. These are the days that we dream of as bow hunters. We're finally down in the thick stuff. Last night, all the corn came out. These guys busted their rear ends to get about 400 acres of corn out the past week, and it's all out. And now we're in the cover, hopefully where the deer are. We've seen several bucks this morning. We got a phenomenal two-year-old with big split G2s. We encountered him. And we really don't know where they're gonna come from, but we're in the cover, and that's where we need to be. We're gonna hang here all day. We got high pressure, beautiful conditions. We only get so many of these days, so we're gonna soak it in.
So knowing that I shot that big deer on November 3rd, he was ultra comfortable coming up that trail, I've been waiting to get into this tree that we're gonna. There's a weather front coming through right now. It's gonna be in the 20s, 10 mile per hour winds, ultra high pressure. All of the corn came out this past week, so deer dumping into the cover, into the middle of the farm where the creek bottom is.
We've seen probably 8 different bucks. A lot of them multiple times. There's a hot doe that came through right at sunrise. And that pretty much ignited this area of the farm. We just haven't seen a mature buck that we want to kill. This is my kind of hunting right here. Wait all year to be able to get into the thick stuff and just wait them out. And take a look around and it's almost unwelcoming. And that's where the beast lives.
It's a big chess match. A lot of people call it a chess match. I call it the beast. The beast isn't one any one individual deer. I'm trying to chase down the beast. And the beast is the pursuit and the journey that animal forces you to go through, the trials and tribulations, the ups and downs, all of the preparation, never quite feeling like you're being your best. And the animal is making me go through that. That is the beast to me. I feel personally like the way that I approach hunting and just pushing myself and setting a little bit of a higher bar, each time I reach a milestone, that translates right into my life. It translates into a lot of people's lives. If you're a driven individual, you try to push yourself and reach goals, there's gonna be failures. There's going to be successes. There's going to be a hell of a lot of preparation on the way and work. But I love all of that. And so that's really what hunting has given me, is a foundation of how I live my life.
The afternoon has certainly slowed down. This is definitely a morning spot. We had good deer movement all morning into about lunchtime. Things have certainly cooled down and the wind has laid down. No eyes on a mature buck yet. We still got the week to give it though.
So we drove in, came
up the hill to the pond dam, parked here, and we walked up past and then down into, that buck was coming right out of this bottom on this wind direction if he's checking this part of the farm. You need to have a good age class, and so that's part of the conservation of herd management. But to define myself just as a hunter or just as a conservationist, I really can't quite do so because it kind of all comes together. I'm managing habitat. I'm trying to improve the habitat for wildlife. I'm trying to take the right deer, the right amount of deer, and all of that hunting adds into the ability to be a conservationist.
Thursday, November 7th, morning hunt. We're back in the 166 stand I killed my best deer out of 2 years ago. We're right at the confluence of some early, young, thick growth. This is the best whitetail habitat you can get are these young trees. Major cold front just came through, super high pressure. Wind is blowing right up this draw. Exact and same conditions as when I killed on this stand before. Strong seasons now, and it feels really good to be able to tag team up on a whitetail. What a hunt.
To me personally, inches is not how I define success. A lot of people use statistics, and it's black and white whether you win or lose. To me, success is really appreciating what hunting can give an individual. What being out in Mother Nature can do for your soul.
Blood. That means I put a good shot on him. So now we're gonna follow the blood trail, okay?
How about you put it in your pocket and then take it out at home?
Okay, all right, we'll put it in my pocket. Okay, it's in my pocket.
Ready?
Oh.
Yeah. That's good blood.
Put it in your pocket.
In my pocket? Okay. Put it in my pocket. We'll take it with us. So look right here. See these things? These are called his tarsal glands. And they smell. Can you smell that? It smells a little bit funky.
Yeah,
that means that he's rutting. He's looking for does to breed. Here's his hoof. They're kinda hard. Feel his hoof. Pretty cool?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty neat. Yep.
Awesome.
Are they cute?
They're so cute, buddy.
Ben has been working hard at killing whitetails and serving his clients in eastern Iowa. This is Ben's first appearance on Whitetail Properties TV. He's had a couple of overwhelming years in his business, personal life, and in the whitetail woods, so this one is extra sweet for all involved. Ben has a true passion for his family and the outdoors, and it shows. It is hard to beat a classic rut hunt on the downwind side of an outside corner of a bedding area. This is the perfect spot to catch a big boy cruising during the day. The takeaway is that it may take some time before you realize your QDM goals, but QDM is about so much more than just killing deer. QDM is about stewardship, and that's good for all wildlife species, their habitats, and our hunting heritage.